7 Secret Study Tips to Score Highest in Exams. Do you ever feel like your study habits simply aren't cutting it? Do you wonder what you could be doing to perform better in class and on exams? It's never too early or too late to develop good study habits. The sooner you get into a good study groove, the easier everything will be, and the more your chances of getting good marks will improve. 1. Pick a place and time. Everyone has their own idea about the best place and time to study. Whether it's your bedroom at night or the library after school, find a study space and a regular study time that works for you and stick with it. Set up your study space. Your study space should be quiet, comfortable, and distraction-free. It should make you feel happy and inspired. Decorate it with your favorite pictures or objects. If you want to listen to music or burn incense, pick a space that lets you do that. Find your best time. Some people work better in the morning. Others work better at night. Work out which time suits you and plan to study then. Don't study much later than your usual bedtime. Pushing yourself late at night can make you too tired to study properly. 2. Discover your learning style. Most of us have a preferred way of learning. Get to know the learning style you're most comfortable with and study in the ways you learn best. Note that these styles are just a way to think about different studying techniques. They're not hard and fast rules that say you should only study in one way. Try each of these out and see which ways you prefer. Auditory learners. Auditory learners learn best through their sense of hearing. This means they remember and understand new concepts better when they are explained out loud, even if they're doing the speaking themselves. They can even better retain knowledge when new ideas are paired with nonverbal sounds such as music, drum beats, or clapping. Visual learners prefer to learn by seeing. Try using colors in your notes and draw diagrams to help represent key points. You could try to remember some ideas as images. Tactile, kinesthetic learners prefer to learn by doing. Try using techniques like role-playing or building models to revise key points. 3. Implementing auditory learning style. Children who are auditory learners often love music and can remember the words to songs they hear. They can easily follow spoken directions and, if they don't understand something, will often say, "Tell me again." Auditory learners like to read out loud, rather than silently, even when they're alone. How to help auditory learners excel? If your child has a lesson to learn, try recording them reading the lesson out loud and give them the audio to listen to later. When they're stumped by a new concept, start a conversation about it, and let your child work through the logic of the problem by talking to you about it. When they're trying to memorize something, suggest making up a silly song about it. Auditory learners are also often intrigued by wordplay and language patterns. For early readers, try books by Shel Silverstein and Dr. Seuss. 4. Use visual learning style. How to recognize visual learners. Visual learners can often be found at the front of the classroom, soaking up whatever they see their teacher write on the board. They are fascinated by bright colors and motion and will often use posters and mobiles to brighten their rooms. They like to draw and paint. How to help visual learners excel? If your child is a visual learner, surround him or her with books. You'll notice that even before he or she can read, your child will be interested in bright pictures and the stories they represent. A visual learner is probably also a budding artist. To help them remember information more clearly, stock up art supplies that they can use to create visual representations of what they're learning. Visual learners can create drawings to help remember important facts, identify the main elements of a storyline, and solidify the meaning of new words in their heads. 5. Kinesthetic learning style. The most physical of all the learning styles, kinesthetic learners absorb information best through touch, movement, and motion. The word kinesthetic refers to our ability to sense body position and movement. This means that to really understand something, they need to touch it, feel it, and move it around. How to recognize kinesthetic learners? They're the kids who love building sets, model kits, and interactive displays at the children's museum. They often tear things apart just so they can learn about them. If kinesthetic learners are offered the choice in art class, they'll choose modeling clay over pencils or paint. From an early age, they'll reach for books that encourage interaction pop-ups, little doors that open and close, or books with textures that can be touched or petted. How to help kinesthetic learners excel. Whenever possible, offer your kinesthetic learner things to hold in their hands. Physical math manipulatives, such as pattern blocks and base 10 blocks, can help kinesthetic learners internalize a new math concept. Help your child practice spelling by getting them letter-shaped magnets they can move around on the fridge. Give kinesthetic learners textured paper to write on and a variety of different sized pencils and pens to choose between. 6. Study small chunks at a time. If you want to remember information over the long haul, don't try to cram it all in during one sitting. Instead, use an approach called spaced repetition. Break the information into parts. Learn one new part at a time over the course of days or weeks. Review your earlier acquisitions each time you study. The brain stores information that it thinks is important. So, when you regularly go over a topic at set intervals over time, it strengthens your memory of it. 7. Quiz yourself. Challenge yourself to see what you can remember. Quizzing yourself is like practicing for the test, and it's one of the most effective methods of memory retention. If it's hard to remember the information at first, don't worry. The struggle makes it more likely that you'll remember it in the end. If you like this video, please subscribe and write your thoughts on comment section. Thank you for watching.